Sega. Hey guys, Scorch82 here, and I'm bringing you a special Let's Play, one of a particularly new game that I'm going to be playing through nearly blind, Mad World, brought to us by Sega. This is a really interesting game. I've only played through the first chapter just so I can get a feel for kind of what's going on, but we're going to jump right into what is going to be the trippiest game show you will ever see. Oh my gosh. I can't wait to see what happens again. So it brings in the beginning here with the Sin City style comic pictures of
As you can see, all eight bridges to Jefferson Island have been cut. There is no traffic getting on or off the island.
We are in hour 15 of the communications blackout with Jefferson Island, leaving the residents there effectively cut off from the outside world.
No way.
Yes, they're demanding that we not approach the city, and we've been told anyone who does will be met with force. But look, let me make this perfectly clear. We have no intention of giving in to any such demands.
No! Oh, my God! Run! Run!
My fellow citizens, first, I assure you that all necessary measures are being taken. I have personally authorized a special team of Marines into the field. They'll be working closely with our intelligence agencies to bring this matter to a swift and peaceful conclusion.
So this is Varigan City. It's been taken over by a terrorist group. And their angle is a sick and twisted, sadistic game show called Death Watch. We'll be briefed on the basics of said game show in a bit. Let's enjoy some cinematics. Crash! All the blood, oh my god. Cue us. Don't we look so cool? Smoking and everything. Yeah.
Who? Me? Ready as always.
So I don't know if anybody's ever seen the movie Running Man, or The Running Man, but it's basically the same premise, where it's a game show that's designed to kill its participants. It wasn't actually too bad of a movie, if you like Schwarzenegger, that is. Alright, so let's go to the map. First stage, Varigan City. The games begin right here in Varigan City Center, but this is only the beginning. Use our convenient rail system and shop, see downtown, or tour a factory. Each place has its own ways to kill, because variety is the spice of death. Let's select it. Our first area is guarded by a contestant by the name of Little Eddie. Varigan Central Station welcomes you. Enjoy our human waste bins. Put out society's trash 24/7. Commodes, what better place to flush a John? Runaway train. Look, Ma, no brakes. But first, a message from your sponsor. Let's go. Death Watch ranking 256 against Little Eddie ranked 178. Yes, I take the challenge. This first section here is a bit of a tutorial.
Come on, man! Don't kill me!
Crack! Splat!
Impressive. Most impressive. Your skills 13. Are sure to please my client. Well, anyone else here feel they deserve a sponsor?
Well, I do.
Apparently not. Congratulations, contestant. My client will be delighted.
Hey, I could use a sponsor.
Who's there? Show yourself!
Look at us swaggering up like that.
There is a signing bonus, right?
Of course.
Badass logo.
But I wouldn't spend your bonus just yet. He's already killed 2 dozen bigger than yourself.
Matrix action right there.
Bigger don't mean better.
Apparently not. Consider yourself sponsored. Signing bonus is 10,000. Survive and you'll be paid in full. While you're alive and in the good graces of Death Watch control, I'll supply you with such weaponry as you require.
Sounds like we got a deal.
You can call me 13, as I represent sponsor number 13. And your name? For contract purposes, of course.
Jack. Just Jack.
My name's not Jack.
Very well, just Jack.
For the purposes Shall of said begin? Game?
You see the communicator there.
Okay.
I want you to put it in your ear. Using it to keep you abreast of critical developments as the game progresses, so don't take it out.
I'm not attempting to talk over the cutscene, so I apologize if I end up doing so. Gears of War, anyone?
Let the games begin.
So this is going to require a lot of Wii remote movement, so this might be a little interesting while I'm in the middle of recording. So here's our control scheme. We move and set camera angle and jump with the nunchuck, and all of our attacking is going to be done with the Wii remote.
On Jefferson Island, just perfect weather for our unwilling contestants to compete in the Varigan City Death Watch.
So if you earn that many points, you get that bonus.
And along with my co-commentator, Chris Creasy, I'll be giving you a
1.6 million points to get to Little Eddie.
With access to the more than 10,000 gamblers in this city, you can be sure not to miss a single disembowelment.
Right. Now we learn whether you are worth your $10,000 first contract. Press A button. Throw a punch. Combo. Use the Wii remote to deliver an uppercut. You can land it. Shake it for a back fist. Okay, and then hold B to take out the chainsaw. Down for a vertical slice. Horizontal, right side swipe. Backflip. And you can attack while jumping, so it's kind of nice. It's really hard to kind of get a feel for the action while that guy's talking, because you got to read and pay attention at the same time, but we'll get into more of the combat later, but for said sake, let's jump over these pile of scrap cars. Kill seekers, no need to go easy on such wastes of skin. Press the A button to let loose. A button to attack. So this is our first example of a finisher move with the A button. Shake the Wii remote and execute the finishing move. We need to do one more with the B button finisher now. So when the finisher icon shows up at the bottom, you press the associated button. And then, if prompted, the right motion on the Wiimote. Smash his heart. We gotta do the A button finisher. Trying to grab you. Swing the Wii remote around. Eventually you should let loose. If you get tired of doing so, I think maybe the only way to do it is to let go.
and terror that just
some of the moves will actually finish.
It's the little things in life.
After you do such motions, but that one you just kind of let him fly. Grab and hold him. You can move. Throw him by shaking the Wiimote. If they decide to fight back, you can give them a headbutt. The introduction of weapons in the environment. Pick up a tire, hold down the A button, you can shake it, to throw it. Don't limit yourself to tires, anything you can pick up. Basically like the most creative way to do someone in. Get out of the way of the tire, fool. And if you approach somebody, push down on the Wiimote, you can